Now let's see. Today we are going to learn the HCF. HCF is highest common factor. In school time we learned how to calculate the HCF, but today I am going to tell you the simple method how to calculate the HCF within seconds. Okay, let's see if we know that the HCF. In HCF, always remember that if number is small, factorization is easy. We know that if the number is small, then to calculate the HCF, factorization method is easy. Means what? If the two numbers are 16 and 20, we know that the common factors are 2. 2 8s are 16, 2 10s are 20. Now let's 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. 4 and 5, there is no any common factor. So we must have to divide by 4. 4 1s are 4, 5. Again, 5 1s are 5. So this will be the LCM, 2 into 2 into 4 into 5. But in HCF, we just have to take only the common factor. Means what? 2 8s are 16, 2 10s are 20. Again, 2 is a common factor. 2 4s are 8 and 2 5s are 10. But now in 4 and 5, there is no any common factor. So the procedure will stop here. And the HCF will be 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Okay, as simple as that. In this way, we have to calculate the HCF. Means what? We just have to take the common factor, highest common factor. That's why it's called the highest common factor HCF. And in LCM, we have to take the common factor and also we have to multiply it by the uncommon factor also. Means what? By 4 and by 5. Also, we have to multiply by 4 and 5 also to calculate LCM. So HCF is the highest common factor. Only take the common factor. 2 is a common factor. 2 is a common factor. So 2 into 2, 4 is the HCF of 16 and 20, these two numbers. Okay. Now we get here that if numbers are small, factorization method is always easy because we can factorize these numbers easily. So the factorization method is easy if the numbers are small. But if the numbers are large, then what we have to do? Let's see. If someone asks you to calculate the HCF of 780, 1495 and 1755, then what you will do? You know that it is quite difficult to factorize all these numbers and the procedure will be the lengthy. So the simple method is, I will tell you, if the numbers are large like this, then division method is easy. Means what? In division method, take any two numbers. If I take this 1495 and 70, by smaller number divide this large number. Okay, now let's see. 780 ones are 780, so remaining are 715. Then again take this 780, this number we have to take 780. 715 ones are 715, and I got here 80 minus 15, 65. Then again take this 715. We know that 65 tens are 650, 65 elevens are 715, so remainder is 0. So means what? This number is 65 is the HCF of 780 and 1495. Now we have to apply the similar method for these two numbers. Now means what? We have to divide this 1755 by 65. We know that 65 twos are 130. So 130, and here 45 and remaining 5. Now let's see. 65 sevens are 455 and remaining is 0. So the HCF is 65. Now this method is too much simple. We have calculated in within 1 minute this example. If we took the factorization method, then this method will be too much large. So this method is division method is easy if the numbers are large. So I can write down here, if numbers are small, always use factorization method. And factorization method means what? We know that factorization method. When 16, 20, these are the two numbers and we have to calculate the HCF. Then take the common factor 2. 8s are 16, 2 10s are 20. Again 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. Then again there are no any factor, common factor between 4 and 5. So 2 2s are 4. 4 will be the HCF. This is the factorization method. It is easy for the small number. But if numbers are large, like we have solved the previous example, then division method is easy. Means what? If there are the four numbers A, B, C, D, and someone asks you to calculate the HCF of this number, then first calculate the HCF of these two numbers, and then again calculate the HCF of these two numbers, and then again calculate the HCF of these numbers. So we will get the HCF of these four numbers. And if the numbers are 5, then take the HCF of this number, then take the HCF of this number, then again take the HCF of this HCF, and then take the HCF of these two numbers. Okay, means what? Likely what? We have calculated the HCF of big numbers here, 780, 1495 and 1755. These three numbers was there and we have calculated the HCF as 1495. We divided the 1495 by 780 and we got here it as 65 as the HCF of 780 and 1495. Then we took the HCF of also 65 and 1755. We divided the 1755 by 65 and we got zero remainder. So 65 is the HCF, these three numbers. Don't worry, we have to take more example on how to calculate the HCF of big numbers, large numbers. Let's see. Now let's see, if someone asks you to calculate the HCF of these three numbers, 264, 440 and 726, we know that the factorization method would not be easy because it is lengthy method. So if the numbers are large, we know that the division method is easy. So take the division, means what? 440, we have to divide this 440 by this 264. Now let's see, 264 ones are 264. So I got here 176. This 264 176 ones are 176. So remaining numbers are 88. Again, this take the 176 here. So 81 twos are 176. We know that. So remaining is 0. So the HCF of this two number is 88. Now take the HCF of 88 and 786, 726. So I must have to divide this 726 by 88. Let's see, 88 8s are 704. You can calculate 88 8s are 704. So the 76 minus 4, 22 are the remaining number. So again take this 88 and we know that 22 4s are 88, remaining are 0. So the HCF is 22. So the 22 is the HCF of 264, 440 and 726. And this is the best method. The numbers are large. And so the important thing is only this. If the numbers are small, always use factorization method. And if the numbers are large, then the division method is easy. This is what we will learn. Okay, practice is the only one solution to get perfect in this method. So practice it. As we know, the practice makes one perfect. So practice it daily. You will feel it easy. Thank you.